Had to get myself a protein bar, you know. I had to get that food. That good, good. Is that what I think it is? Okay, something kind of similar. Not the same thing.
Oh my, look who's awake.
Yeah.
Good morning, sleepyhead.
It's that bed. Feels like a cloud.
I know. Daniel, breakfast time.
Damn,
your
Daniel.
Grandma, show me your pop star.
Steven. Your grandson needs to eat now. You can show him the boxcar later. I love how they're getting along.
Need any help?
Do you need help or anything?
Oh, don't worry. I can do this in the dark. But thanks for the offer.
All right, all right.
Too many hands in the kitchen.
He's done playing.
We had an express delivery with the passengers, but the engine broke down.
Yep, has to go straight to the workshop.
Good. No trains in the kitchen, remember?
Gotcha, Chief.
Choo-choo!
You know, it's probably not them that's gonna call.
Sugar.
The police is probably going to be...
He can fix his trains, but not my kitchen.
Going to be a neighbor.
Did I make enough? Everything's okay?
It's great. As usual.
You're the best cook ever.
Looks like you're getting cozy with this new country life after all.
Yeah, it's nice to be far away from everything. Feels like we're the only ones out here.
Well, that's exactly why we love it. It feels safe, unlike the big city.
I get it.
I like it. It's cool here.
Well, bless your soul. You'd get along good with our neighbors. We try to lend a hand.
Oh.
Like to Charles next door. He lost his wife, and things have been hard on him and his son. He would just get lost in Seattle.
That's why the grandma looks familiar.
But we're all taking care of him here.
How old is his son?
I think he's your age.
Ooh.
Hey, a little younger. Depends. Maybe like a year younger. Yeah, Captain Spirit's right next door, motherfuckers. That kid that trips out a lot. Yeah, it's insane imagination. Or just might be the shrooms in this food. That was cutting it close, kid.
Oh, I thought Steven was a fast eater.
Hey, Grandma, I wanted to ask you something about that locked room upstairs.
I told you there is nothing to see in it, Daniel.
Why were you in it this morning then?
Because there's a lot of old junk in there. And besides, it's not safe for you to explore, okay?
But we'll be fine.
Wonder if Mom had powers.
Why don't you go explore outside?
Maybe that's why she
you
had
sure
to leave.
You sure look like you're getting better. Get some fresh air.
I'll wait for Sean, and then we'll go. We won't be loud. Promise.
But be careful nobody sees you. Stay in the back, okay?
Maybe you should tell him that it was Karen's room.
It's just a room now, Sean. Nothing to see.
Daniel needs that. He doesn't know anything about her.
I know, poor thing. But his mother isn't in there anymore. So nobody goes in the room, okay? I'm
Understood.
Serious.
Understood.
Did Mom ever contact you? She only talked to Dad a few times. Then she was gone.
Yes, she was. You know, Sean, I don't really want to talk about this anymore.
It's your daughter, though.
Anyway, you have to respect my rules under my roof, okay?
Of course. Always.
I appreciate that, Sean. Now you better go find your brother.
I wonder what the hell happened to his mom.
There's a shed with some old toys outside. I'll bet Steven has the key.
Tanny, old freak. Thank you.
Okay. Every time I'm like done eating something, doesn't matter what I eat, except for sushi. Sushi, apparently I don't get the gunk in my throat, but fuck. Night in the forest. Sometimes it always makes me wonder if they actually do slip in like a real book in here. So like Night in the Woods. What? Why would you keep that? Too fucking creepy. Demon blonde. Yeah, we probably have some new, aw, man. That's sad. That happened on December 2nd, 2016. Burning cold. What the fuck? So that was in, let's see, December 5th. Oh, so we've been in the house for a few days then. Because December 5th, it looks like probably like a day or two passed. And then that's December 6th. Doing drawing of so we can tell which drawings are Daniel's and which one's the older brother's. Clearly tell. Reynolds rules. What is this rules? Discretion, disconnection, no phones or no internet, daily chores, homework for Daniel. So he's still trying to educate the kid. That's good. It's like, yeah, even though we're on the run and all, it still needs to get educated. I'm the same way. It's like, yeah, you kind of still need to get smart, kid. Okay.
I miss Dad and his silly Santa Gringo accent.
Santa Gringo? I want to hear that.
I heard Claire rehearse some songs. She's got the groove.
She's got the groove.
Sorry for getting upset, Sean. I just don't feel comfortable talking about all this.
It's fine, really. We don't have to. You're not the only one Karen hurt. Hey, Claire?
What's on your mind, Sean?
What did you think of Dad?
What did you think of Dad? You can tell me. I won't get mad.
Well, your father was... he was his own person.
That's it? I mean, I know you guys didn't really get along.
It's just... Esteban was very different from us. And he never took a single step to change any of that.
Never needed to.
Sounds like Dad. He wasn't one to smooth things over.
Trust me. I know the type. But he did raise you boys on his own. Can't argue with that.
Yeah. He worked his ass off for us. Wish I realized that sooner.
Don't worry, Sean.
Do you know anything about Dad's funeral?
There was a service. We couldn't make it in time, but we sent flowers. I'm sorry, Sean.
It's okay. I just want to make sure somebody took care of him.
Hopefully, you can go visit him at some point.
At some point? Yeah. What's the story with your neighbor?
Charles? Oh, poor man used to be a basketball coach, but had to move out here after his wife's passing. He's got a job at the rail yard now, and, well, he's still recovering.
Wow. I mean, that's sad.
We tried to give him a hand, keep an eye on his drinking problem. His son Chris is a little angel, though. I think Daniel would be a good influence on him. He's got a great role model, after all.
Oh, shucks.
I'm trying my best.
How long were you two married?
How long have you and Stephen been married?
Oh, my. Forever. But a good forever.
Since the Titanic ages?
Years.
Man, that's more than twice my age. You both were married during Y2K.
Thanks for making me feel even older. I assume you must have a girlfriend or...
Almost.
I almost started dating this one person. But I guess... not anymore.
I understand. I'm sorry, honey. It's not fair that you have to deal with all this. Things will change.
I hope.
Can get to the slick dick base.
Well, thanks, Claire.
You are very welcome. It's always a pleasure to speak with my grandsons.
Aquarium? Oh, what book do you have there? Oh, tidy.
Tried one of Claire's books yesterday. It's basically a telenovela with white old women.
Relax and draw? Finally. Because I missed out on one drawing opportunity. Sure. Another subject.
Oh, don't draw me like this, Sean. I'm a mess.
Hold still, you...
I'm drawing the whole room.
Good. It's so nice to see you practice. You're so passionate.
I'm not moving.
I've looked enough. Hope I looked good. Time to draw now.
Wish I could draw that fast.
I'm not moving. Hope I look good.
Stop moving. You're moving!
I think I'm ready to draw this.
I'm not moving.
Shh.
Hope I look good.
That's his superpower, is being a fucking artist.
I'm not moving.
Weave kindness
Hope
into
I look
your
good.
Daily narrative. Beautiful.
Pretty good. But I can add more details if I want.
More details.
Okay. Got it. I've looked enough. Time to draw now.
Hope I look good.
Daniel, are you okay?
Cool. I think I'm ready to draw this.
I'm not moving. Hope I look good.
Daniel? All right there. Having a stroke? Sucks that I missed that other one. I missed a couple drawing opportunities.
I'm gonna pick these up. Gives me something to work on when they're all watching TV.
Fireplace. Yeah, that's a nice looking fireplace.
Such a big fireplace. And not even needed. That's luxury.
Yeah.
Feeling of love. Cash and princess.
Grandma's into the naughty shit.
Pleasure.
Sounds like a Christian.
Does Claire read all these?
It's a Christian household, of course she does. I think they're, yeah, I'm guessing they're Christian.
Oh, this looks cool. Too bad it's broken.
Yeah, Catholics read that smut too.
Grandma, where are the fish?
Well, there's only one, and he's terribly shy.
We did ask her something, or tried to.
Oh, this looks cool. Too bad it's broken.
We can't ask her the question? Shit. Thanks, Daniel.
I heard Claire rehearse some songs. Yeah. She's got the groove. I haven't seen any actual fish in there since we got here. Have you ever seen any actual fish in there?
Never.
Now we should probably head out. Let's see. Discuss.
Whoa. Look at all these decorations.
That's so cool.
Okay. So, one second. We need to ask Steven.
About the tree, Daniel?
Of course I am. When do we start?
I'll get it this weekend.
Toilets. Oh, this is his office.
I think I need a handy assistant.
Oh.
Can you hand me the glue in the cupboard behind me?
Sure. Hold on.
Glue.
Whoa! Ooh. Careful. Sorry, I forgot. That thing isn't too stable. Let me just...
Okay. Sorry.
My fault. Your grandmother keeps telling me, but I'm a lazy old man. Hey, can you close the door? I want to talk for a second.
Oh.
Sure thing, Gramps.
It's the power cable, of course. Yeah, it happens all the time. So, listen, I've noticed things with Daniel. You know what I'm talking about, don't you?
I have a feeling he knows about the fucking powers. It's not hard to... They're family. They gotta know, man.
Yeah. I do.
But how the heck is that possible? I mean, he can... Well, you know more than me.
Not really. It started in Seattle after...
Dad got shot.
Everything happened. I wish I could explain, but that's how it is now. And we have to live with it.
I really don't know what to think. He needs a doctor. Or something.
Then I'd probably never see him again.
Yeah, I get it. He needs you. More than anything else. And by the way, let's keep this between us.
Good.
Claire has a lot of strong beliefs. She wouldn't understand.
I think it's part of the devil.
She adores Daniel. And just wants both of you to be safe and happy. What I'm trying to say is maybe you should... Stay here with us. I know you boys plan to run to Mexico, but...
We have a home in Puerto Lobos. Dad wanted to return there. Two Mexican boys out on the run? That won't be a secret in Beaver Creek for long.
America is your home. with us. And you have to think about your brother, you know, his future, all
America.
That stuff.
It's too dangerous for us to stay here. And for you guys, too.
It's dangerous to be on the road. Do you think your father would have wanted this for his kids?
No.
Of course not. But everything's different now.
I know. I know. Well, just think about it. But don't torture yourself.
I will. Hey, Claire said you had the keys for the tool shed?
Oh, sure. Here. You guys enjoy the sun.
Man, I hope that cabinet's not going to be a problem. Feel like the cabinet's gonna fall on Grandpa and kill him.
Be careful with that shed. It's probably a mess inside.
Thanks.
So here, it's good to see you in my lair. Even though you were afraid to come in here.
Disco ball.
Really? How come you have a disco ball? Are you like throwing parties and stuff?
No, this is a souvenir, you know. I actually met your grandma during a disco night.
Sweet.
Claire told me you guys have been married for like 40 years, so it kind of makes sense.
That sure was a long time ago, but we stuck together, you know, through thick and thin.
That's cool.
Well, call me old-fashioned, but I think that's how marriage should be.
They're committing. Guess that's Mom.
Oh. You found this. I just forgot to,
It's okay. It's been a while since I've seen her face.
Yeah. I like taking a look at it from time to time.
It's her daughter.
Doesn't it hurt?
Yeah, it does. But she's still my daughter, you know. I can't approve what she's done, but
what the fuck did she do?
I understand.
Good. I don't.
I'm sorry, Jean. Please don't. Please don't say anything to Claire about this, okay?
Don't worry. I won't. Steven sure takes his hobby.
Everyone has to have their hobby. As long as you have the passion for it. Fuck yeah, go with it. Ollie over there.
I'm sorry, Sean. I know you guys miss your games and your websites. But trust me, a break from all this can only do you good. You know, and it's safer that way.
Yeah.
I mean, I haven't played games in like since October, so. Drawing.
Man. Who did this?
Oh, it was our neighbor's son, Chris. Yeah, I helped him and his dad build that treehouse.
Why are you holding a fire sword?
I'm not sure. You know, that kid sure has an imagination.
He definitely does.
There you are, Sean. Got the key? Hey, I have to go out and run some errands. Can you do me a big favor? Do you know how to work a washing machine?
Since I was about 8.
Of course. Can you throw in yours and your brother's clothes after the next load? They're in the bathroom basket.
Totally, yeah. No problem.
Thank you so much. Feel free to start tidying your stuff, too. It's good for the health to keep a house clean.
Definitely.
Upstairs or downstairs?
And remember, for your own safety, no phone and no internet. I know, boring rules.
Don't worry, Claire. Hey, Daniel! There's work for you.
No. I'm busy.
Busy my ass! Come over here.
Sounds like it's upstairs. He's upstairs, little punk. Wait a minute. Is he behind the fucking door? Oh. Wow. Underneath the bed? Typical underneath the bed thing. I wonder if he can levitate himself. Oh, should probably look up. He's crawling on the walls. Or make sure he's not underneath this. Huh. Frame's crooked.
Oh, gee. Don't know why crooked frames stress me out like this.
Oh, he better not be in that door.
This room. Used to be Karen's room.
Wait, that room's open. Or, oh, it looks like it.
I wonder what they've done with it.
Is it taped? It looks like it's duct tape.
Better not sneak in. They won't like it.
Let's see, is he in the bathroom? He's probably not. I don't know.
I know you're in there. Gotcha. What the?
Behind you.
Yeah. Very funny. No more hiding. Seriously.
Okay. What do I have to do?
You tidy the mess in our room, and I take care of the laundry.
Yeah.
Cool?
Yeah, sure. It's hot.
I know. Thanks.
Okay, so where is that washing machine?
Okay, easy peasy.
It's gonna use his powers. Guessing it's down here, and it's probably gonna be.
Yeah. Let me just throw our clothes in the machine and we're good.
Where is it? It's probably in here. No. Where the fuck is the room where you washed a... Where would it be? I don't know where the washroom is. It's gotta be upstairs. Did you tie the room? Dude.
Daniel,
okay.
Total thug in his new pajamas.
It's the damn washroom. It's not there. It's definitely not there. Where is there? I must have missed a room. Gotta be a door we can, like, interact with. Oh, this is open. Dark as shit. Here we go. Let's see, what's the note?
As always with Claire, I can't really tell if this is cute or bossy.
That makes whites and clothes ever. But if you have good detergent, you don't have to worry about it. Use 1 cup of detergent, red box, for each load. If you want to wash my clothes... Use the delicates cycle.
How many programs does this thing have?
It's an older machine.
It will do.
I didn't have a choice, so if we broke any of the rules, it's not my fault. Oh, what door is this? Probably to the basement. Oh, no, it's cupboard.
Hmm.
Alrighty, dude. You ready to go outside?
Daniel, you ready? We can go out now.
Yes.
It's like right there. It's like he teleported right when we started that. It's like, yeah.
Man, finally.
Winter Wonderland.
Outside. Reminds me of the cabin.
I know, he was next to me and all that, and then he's in another room.
Oh! Oh, oh, oh!
Watch out for the pack.
Get ready for storage wars.
What's wrong?
Is that the right key?
Frozen shut.
Oh.
Of course.
Sean, look!
Oh, this is where he falls. He probably thought he did it. Good reaction time, though. I give Daniel credit. He had some good reaction time to that.
Did you see that?
Yeah. We did. It looks like you're okay, though.
You were almost floating. I was. I could feel myself in the air. It was awesome. That's an awesome costume. Who's your favorite superhero? I love Power Bear.
We're both fans of Power Bear.
I have the Mega Power Bear. You should check it out. Dude, that's so cool.
Chris, oh God. Look, I am so sorry. Are you okay?
Dad, I'm fine. I promise.
I bet this...
Are you sure? Listen, I shouldn't...
Bet the dad's gonna be a problem.
Do you know them?
It's okay, Dad. They're cool. He loves superheroes. Even Power Bear.
Ah, gotcha. Hey there. Are you staying with the Reynolds? Oh, yeah. They're our grandparents. I see. Oh, jeez, Chris. You don't have any damn shoes on.
I hope he doesn't know about us.
I'm sorry, buddy.
Might have fucked up.
Let's get you inside.
But we don't want to lie either.
Yeah. Okay, Dad.
Thanks, guys. Oh, and, if Claire asks, tell her everything is fine. Sure. No problem. Cool. See you around then.
Thanks, guys.
You must have sobered up real fucking quick.
We will.
Daniel, did you forget everything about the rules already?
Sorry, Sean. Did you want me to let him fall? Really?
No. We'll concede to that.
No, you did the right thing. But listen, we can't let anybody know. We have to keep a low profile out here.
He's like my age. I bet you would have done the same exact thing. Don't be mad.
I'm not mad, dude. It's
worried.
It's over.
Scared.
Damn. Remember that we're hiding out, so no training and no showing off your power. From now on, you stick with me all the time, okay?
To be honest, if I had his power, I would be a... I'd be a prankster all the fucking time. I'd be using my powers in the most, like, dumb way. I'll be trying to cook with telekinesis and shit. So I'll be sitting at the, dining room table while I'm cooking things and everything like that. The next morning, so a day has passed, and so far the cops haven't arrived to the house. That's a good thing. I'm at the neighbor's.
Oh, fuck.
Shit.
That kid never listens.
Guess we gotta go over there. Let's get dressed. It's like the dad's home too. Let's see.
Okay. Time to get Daniel at the Erickson's.
Something's gonna have to escalate. I'm just kind of wondering what's going to make that happen.
Claire? Steven?
Anyone home?
Anybody home?
I wonder where the hell they would go. They're retired.
Well, looks like I'm home alone.
They didn't finish that yet. Or no, they did. It's just white on white. Oh the tree's right. Up.
Sunday morning.
Oh, they're at church.
We had a good time decorating the tree together last night. Daniel loved it.
So if they're at church... Oh, here's a note.
Well, I guess they won't be back for at least 2 hours. Maybe I could use Steven's laptop?
No.
It's been ages since I've had news from the real world.
Remember the rules. You gotta follow the rules. Don't do it. Don't break the rules. We're already on the grandparents' good side. We don't fuck that up.
Okay. Let's get this brack back home now.
They'll probably know if you're on the fucking computer. Merry Christmas. So, how many neighbors are over here? So, that's their house. Of course, there's one.
Why does Daniel never listen?
This looks like two.
Maybe I'm too soft with him.
Looks like there might be a third neighbor over there too. So there's about three neighbors. But yeah, they're out in the sticks. Makes me wonder if they're in the treehouse.
Wow. That's a lot of beer.
Mm-hmm. Should see what's inside the house.
Daniel, what's going on here?
Sean, wait. Don't freak out. I can't explain.
Let me tell him. Sean, I know it sounds crazy, but I have a superpower. You saw me yesterday. I know you did. I was flying. I can move things. Objects. With my mind.
Oh. A superpower. Really?
Yes.
Daniel.
Well, that's pretty cool, Chris. So, you're like a superhero?
I'm Captain Spirit. I can bend any matter to my will. But that's my secret identity, so you can't tell anybody.
Oh, I can keep a secret, Captain Spirit.
Now you're an official member of the Spirit Squad. If you betray us, I'll disintegrate you. Nah, just kidding. Oh yeah, we need a... team signal. Totally!
I'm gonna be Super Wolf.
We're gonna get dragged in this. Professor Diaz? Silver Runner. El Diablo Loco.
I don't know. Something cool like El Diablo Loco.
Oh, you said Diaz Loco.
Sounds like a supervillain's name. But, okay.
Okay, guys, I think we're ready to roll. Excuse me. Who are you?
I'm Sean.
Sorry, man.
Brother.
We're here for Daniel. Hey, let's make it official. I'm Charles Erickson.
Nice to meet you.
Hope you know that Daniel and Chris are a dangerous team. We better watch out, or they're gonna take over the world.
Yeah, they share a lot of things. As thick as thieves.
Can we go get the Christmas tree now? We're both ready to fly.
Yes, yes, yes. The team has been waiting too long. Hey, you should come along too. There's nothing going on over here.
Yes! Can't wait to see all the decorations! And Sean, we could buy Christmas presents for Grandma and Grandpa.
I don't think we're supposed to leave.
Well, they'll worry if we leave the house. And remember, you still have to get better, Daniel.
Sean, come on. You know I haven't done anything fun since I got sick. It's the first time I've been out for days.
Don't do this to me.
Not for long. The market's only a few miles away. Anyway, they'll be at the service for at least another hour.
Yeah, Sean, I can show Daniel around. You can come with us. Please say yes. Please, please, please.
Do you have sunglasses at least?
Okay, you win.
We're gonna get spotted. Fight.
So let's go.
Yes! Yeah!
See? Dangerous. Okay, team, give me a time out to clean up the back seat. I'll honk when I'm done.
Ooh, can I use the bathroom?
Of course. Oh, you'll see my comic books. I'm glad you're coming too. Hey, you want to see my toys?
Oh, score! The new hot dog man?
Since you're a new member of the team, you have to know everybody. These are Captain Spirit's friends. And his enemies.
Dude, that's pretty cool.
Can you guess who are the good guys and the villains?
Let's see.
Let's see. He's a good guy.
Okay.
Yeah, they're villains.
The bad guys? The good guys.
I think I remember.
Easy, right?
I think this one, Dino, might be a bad guy.
Good
guy. Good guy.
Maybe tricky.
I think we got it. Oh. Okay.
Look closely.
Okay. How did I do?
Not bad. You're almost right.
Oh.
It was a bit tricky.
Is the dinosaur a good guy?
Let me introduce them to you. This is Team Spirit, good guys. There's the Forest Warrior, Power Bear, Marty Rex, and Sky Pirate.
So, who are the bad guys?
That's Noctarius and the Shark Stinger. There's also Snowmancer, but he's out in the garden. But they're all working for Mantroid, who is the real supervillain. You should see his evil planet.
Why doesn't Captain Spirit stop him?
He tried, but failed. That's why he needs Super Wolf. You know, Daniel. To prevent Mantroid from hurting other people.
Yeah. Strength in numbers. Sounds like Mantroid is in trouble.
Just wait until he sees what Captain Spirit can do now.
Yeah. About that. Aren't you afraid? Maybe it's not a good idea to disclose all your powers like this. That Mantroid guy could be watching you, you know?
Even better. So he'll know he better stay away from us.
Anyway, you shouldn't let anyone know about this. Not even your father.
I'm definitely not telling Dad. I don't want to freak him out. He's worried about other stuff anyway.
Chris, it's none of my business, but are you and your dad okay?
What do you mean?
I don't know. Claire seems to be worried about you guys. Yesterday, Stephen and her talked about your dad. I think they had a talk with him.
Claire's always worried. We're cool. Totally. He's just... he has a hard time being on his own. That's all.
Well, I can understand that. But I hope you know you're not alone.
Thanks, Sean. But I don't feel scared anymore. I have the power, and I have Daniel.
Ah, too cool.
Sorry, the water eater is still broken.
There's the signal. Come on, Daniel.
Hey! Pro tip, don't go in there.
Yeah.
Okay, squad. Let's roll.
You dust ovened it?
You need my jacket?
Kids in the back.
I don't want you catching another cold.
No, I'm good. Thanks.
And don't be waving your arms around when I'm driving, okay?
Yeah. Remember, Daniel, don't mess around.
All right.
Wonder if me and the dad's gonna have a discussion.
Thanks for clearing the snow from the porch. You're awesome.
You're welcome, Dad.
I did that. So it seems like some of the things I did in the game, in the Captain Spirit game, traveled over. Sweet. What's gonna happen at the market? Someone's gonna point us out. It's like, oh shit, those are the fugitives, aren't they? Will people even remember after like 2 months pass, though? I don't think they would. Most people don't. Unless they are still reporting about it. Thing is, this is a small town too, man. We really shouldn't be out going out into town. But we don't have a choice. I guess this needs to happen for the story to continue. Is it doggo? Oh, Christmas tree, oh, Christmas tree. It's okay, only buddy. June and I'm singing it.
Hey!
You guys go ahead and we'll come back to meet you, okay? Brothers meeting.
Sure,
but
don't get lost.
Dude, what the fuck are you doing? I can't believe it. How many times do we have to keep going over the rules?
Don't show the power. I know. But Chris thinks he can do all this cool stuff. I wish he could. He reminds me of Noah. I just miss having friends, Sean.
Stop lying to Chris. The thing is, if you keep lying to Chris, he might do something stupid.
I know, man. But you can't lie to friends about something like this. He could get in trouble thinking he can make shit fly. Or he could get hurt.
So you want me to tell him the truth?
Well, I don't want you to lie anymore. You don't have to tell him everything. But don't let him think he has magic powers, okay? You swear?
You're hallucinating, kid.
Okay. I swear.
Deal. I'm counting on you and Anno.
Are you gonna explain
it? Can I go see Chris now?
Yeah, let's go. But don't forget what I said.
So far, no one's noticed.
Wow. So many trees!
Tree wrapper.
Don't worry. Behold, the giant condom machine. Don't worry. I'll be around. Jeez.
That is a creepy snowman.
No one wasn't that creepy after all.
Hey, what's up?
Nothing. I'll tell you later. So, what do?
We have to pick the one we like. Can Daniel help, Dad?
Of course he can.
Awesome. Come on, no time to lose.
Okay, just pick the one you like and come get me. Deal?
Deal.
I've never been on such a dangerous mission.
Yeah, these wild trees are just waiting to eat us.
We'll have to tame the one we want.
Guess I need to walk around. Oh. Let's see. Find Daniel a Christmas present. Oh, we only have $4, though, dude. Cinder blocks. Is that nuts?
Looks like someone went nuts over these blocks.
I think I heard the,
What about this one?
I think I heard the squirrel. Excuse me, sir. Just kind of walking around, doing some stuff. Santa mailbox.
Dear Santa, we've been good kids this year. Please explain this hot mess.
Sure. I'm fine for now.
Poster.
This is so different from Seattle. Don't know if I can get used to it. Is that a yo-yo? Daniel had one back home. Bet he'd love this.
Don't steal the yo-yo. $10? We don't have that.
Hi, everybody. We're taking a year off to run away from cops. Daniel has got telekinesis now.
Yep.
Hope you're doing well.
Wooden sign.
Holy shit.
We only sell handmade local products.
Handmade local products? That mustn't be cheap at all.
Hey. Hi.
Good morning, young man. It's nice to see a new face in this old town.
Thanks. It's a super cool market you got here.
Small towns are the best for Christmas. Who are you staying with?
The Reynolds?
Everybody knows Steven. He was Beaver Creek's fire chief years ago. You're not his grandson, are you?
Just a family friend.
No, he's just an old family friend.
Gotcha. Anyway, welcome to Beaver Creek. If you need anything, just holler.
Yeah, I have a feeling if we...
better deals in Beaver Creek.
Funny how
$5?
Small towns always sell the same handcrafted crap.
Hey, don't call it crap. Do you have anything cheaper? Oh, maybe food.
Ugh. It's weird to have all this food around after a month of ravioli diet.
Is that cider? Like hot apple cider?
I miss Dad's Christmas at all.
Yo, cinnamon. Fucking slices of orange, star anise. Dude, that must be fucking dope. It has star anise and all that in it.
Too bad we can't come and see. Maybe we'll get some leftover pies and eggnog, at least.
Oh, sit down, Joe. So what are we drawing? Probably the little bit of the market.
Cool. I think I'm ready to draw this.
what I need to focus on now. Background.
Time to take the pen, dude. This place is nice. Pretty good. But I can add more details if I want. Okay. Got it.
Someone playing the guitar?
I've looked enough. Time to draw now.
Not bad.
What are you drawing? Whoa! It's so cool! Are you like a professional?
No. More like the opposite.
You could draw comic books. The awesome adventures of Captain Spirit and Super Wolf.
Pretty rad for Hollywood name. Yeah. I'll think about it.
Hey, can you add something funny to your drawing?
Funny? Like what?
I don't know. Something cool.
Okay. Big question. Zombies or UFO?
UFO?
What about a giant spaceship flying over Beaver Creek?
That sound good.
I've looked enough. Time to draw now.
I hope I can draw like you one day.
I'm sure you will, man.
Still need to find a GIF. Oh! We'll eat for food. Aw, man.
She looks so out of place here. Cool.
She must be from Seattle. I wonder if we'll see this character in the next game. That'd be interesting.
It's me. You've come to take my duality.
Wow.
Wakes the midnight time. I could not see if I were you, were you.
Sounds good.
For me, we play the game.
Now we have to pay her.
And so I asked for your demands. Give me your love, give me your gun. And you traced us back to where we've gone. So the morning came and swept the night away, and I was looking for a amongst the quiet.
I know this song. I'm trying to remember the band that does this song.
Wow, you made it all the way through. Weird. You got a crush on me or something?
No, I...
You're like a siren.
I mean, it was pretty cool. I just...
Relax, dude. It's cool that you listened. People are usually too busy to care.
You have a great voice. You should be on one of those singing shows.
That's kinda nice. Not really my thing, though. I hate